the way that I was raised, the wife would take care of the bills, the husband would go out and make the money.
I thought that the husband makes sure the bills get paid and make sure the family is well taken care of.
Neither Cynthia nor Dexter Brown's expectations were met. No one made a household budget or monitored the spending, and no one kept up with the bills.
The utility bills, the regular bills, we would put that on the back burner and spend the money on the things that we wanted.
I couldn't understand how he could be a budget analyst and handle so much money throughout a day and then come home and everything was a mess.
Including the Browns' marriage.
I started blaming my wife. My wife started blaming me.
Me as a woman, I need to feel safe. And I didn't feel safe.
That's because Cynthia and Dexter were $15,000 in debt. Their electricity and cable were cut off, and all four of their cars were repossessed. When the Browns faced foreclosure on their home, they filed for bankruptcy. Then things got worse. The couple received a second foreclosure notice that said if they did not pay $2,000 immediately, they would be evicted from their home. Cynthia turned to God.
I told him, I said, if you help me to get back on track, I'm going to do the right thing.
And just one day before they were to be evicted, the Browns sold a van they had received as a gift for, you guessed it, $2,000. So they didn't have to leave their home. Now it was time to make good on that promise to God.
I had to swallow my pride and ask for help.
A friend from church helped them sort through their finances and make a budget. But their real breakthrough came when they decided to make tithing their first priority. Then Cynthia added something else to the list.
I just knew that I was supposed to give to the 700 Club, and I knew God was tugging on my heart to give.
So Cynthia made the call and pledged her support to CBN. And as she continued to watch the 700 Club, Dexter noticed something different about his wife.
Her spirit changed. She was a nicer person, a kinder person, and I wanted what she had. So I started watching as well. And every time I watched CBN, it blessed me. So I said, well, maybe we should give more. So we agreed to increase our giving, and now we don't even miss it.
It's been over 7 years since the Browns started budgeting and putting biblical principles to work in their lives. As a result, they've paid off every last penny of their $15,000 debt, and they've worked out the kinks in their marriage.
I'm the bill payer. I'm the one that makes sure all the bills get paid. I make sure I keep up with the checkbook.
Me, on the other hand, I look to do the investing part, the savings and the, you know, negotiating the real estate deals and that type of thing.
Real estate deals? That's right. Dexter and Cynthia now have two houses and are getting ready to buy another. They have a savings account.
And just today, I go to the mailbox and there's a check in the mail. I mean, from out of nowhere. It is like so amazing.
It's a richer and fuller life than the Browns ever had before. And they say it started with two things, surrender and obedience.
Me and my husband, we had to start praying together. We had to start working together. We had to make sure we took care of what was important, the tithing, the offering, and the 700 Club.
At first, I was just selfish. I thought I could manage it all on my own. But it wasn't until I put God first that the blessings truly started to flow. Test God in this area. Give. And God will, in return, give to you.